Summit Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today we're going to be going over a number of different questions that my students have asked. They're pertaining to Google Drive and Google Docs. Now, if you're not familiar with Google Docs, it's just like Microsoft Word. In fact, it has even more features and works offline there, as we're going to find out and how to set up the offline support there for your Google Docs. So let's take a look at these questions. Come on. And the first question comes from Richard. He asks, I am writing a journal using Google Docs. When I close the document and then reopen it later, how can I get it so that it opens right where I left off instead of at the top of the document? Within Google Docs, there isn't a built-in feature that automatically opens a document right where you left off when you reopen it later. However, you can use bookmarks to manually navigate to the last place where you're working within a document. Here's how you can set up bookmarks to help you remember right where you left off. One is actually add a bookmark. So while you're working within your document, simply place your cursor at the exact location where you want to resume later. Then take your mouse and click on the insert menu found at the top. Choose bookmark. This will insert a small blue bookmark icon at that exact location. Now, later, when you return to your document, you can return to that bookmark. So when you reopen up that document, scroll to the top where you find the table of contents if you have one, or a list of bookmarks. But an even easier way for me is to use the keyboard shortcut, which is Ctrl-Alt-N, Ctrl-Alt-B. Press those keys really in quick succession and it will actually jump down to the bookmark. So again, that's Ctrl-Alt-N, Ctrl-Alt-B, and it might take a moment or two for you to learn that new keyboard shortcut, but it comes in handy if you have bookmarks on a very long document. So now let's talk about updating your bookmarks. If you've added more content above the bookmarked location, you might need to adjust the bookmark. Simply delete the old bookmark and add a new one at the updated location. Another way is to use comments. So, an easy way that I found is to simply add comments at important points within the document. These comments can include notes about what you are working on or what needs to be done next. And the next question is, can I open and edit Microsoft Word documents right within Google Docs? And the answer is yes, you can. You can open and edit Microsoft Word documents using Google Docs. And this is because Google Docs offers compatibility with Microsoft Word documents and the formats that end in DOCX. This allows you to work seamlessly and to view, edit, collaborate, as well as do other things on Microsoft Word documents. Now here's how you can do it. You can open the Google Drive account. Once it's open, look for the New button that's found in the upper left-hand corner. Click it and then select File Upload as seen here. Locate and select the Microsoft Word document that you wish to edit. After the document is uploaded, right-click on it, and then select Open With, and then choose Google Docs. The Word document will open in Google Docs, where you can make edits, formatting changes, and more. Google Docs allows you to collaborate in real time with others. You can share the document with collaborators and give them permission to view or edit. Any changes you make will automatically be saved in Google Docs. If you need to download the document to a different file format, simply click on File and then Download and choose the various formats. These include Microsoft Word, PDF, and many more, as you can see here. Now keep in mind that while Google Docs does a great job of maintaining the formatting of Microsoft Word documents, there might be some advanced features or complex formatting that doesn't translate perfectly between the two platforms. So it's always a good practice to review the document after importing to ensure that everything looks just as you intend it to. And the next question is kind of easy there. It is, how can I see my word count within Google Docs? So to do this, click on Tools and then go down right here to Word Count, click it, and there's your word count. You can even have it displayed while you're typing. And the next question is, how do I take my Google document and change it so it's in the landscape mode? So right now it's in the portrait mode, that's the default, but if you want to change this to landscape, click on File, go all the way down to where you have Page Setup, click it, and there's your option right there. This is called the orientation, portrait, or landscape. So if you go landscape, that's going to be laying the pages on the side. And the next question is, how do I change my margins for Google Docs? So if I want to change the margin, simply go up to File, go all the way down to Page Setup, click it, and right here you notice that you have your margins, the top, bottom, left, and right are right here. Go ahead and click it. If I want them to be 1/2 inch, I can go 0.5, tab 0.5, tab 0.5, and tab 0.5. Now my margins are 0.5. Click on OK, and you'll put that into place. And the next question is, how do I insert page numbers into my documents? So to do this, click on Insert and then go down to Page Numbers. And you'll notice that you have options if you want on the upper right or the lower right there. And there are more options as well. You can even have it so that the first page is without the number. And the next question is, how do I do a hanging indent in Google Docs? So to do a hanging indent, highlight your text first, and then simply go over to the ruler and then drag your indent where you want it to be. So there's 1 inch, there's 2 inches. You can put it anywhere that you want. So the next question is, how do I have my text as double spacing? Let me show you. So to do the double spacing on the text, simply highlight the text that you want to have with the double spacing. Go up and click on the double space icon, which is under More, and there's all of your other icons, by the way. And there it is, line and paragraph spacing. Click it and choose the one that you want. So in this case, we want a double, so let's click on double, and there's what double spacing looks like. And a question that I often get is, does Google Docs work offline? Quick answer is yes. So let me show you how to enable offline support for Google Drive and Google Docs and everything else there. So to enable offline support, click on your Google Drive. And once you're in your Google Drive, go into Settings, click it, and click on Settings there. And right away, you'll notice that it says right here, Offline. This allows you to create, open, and edit your recent Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides files on the device while you are offline. All right, so there you go. What this does is it basically copies everything onto your local drive. This works on both Chromebooks as well as your other machines, your other platforms. Hey, so if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, because that's why I base my future videos on, is upon your questions and comments that you leave down there. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel, SummitTeacher7. And also wish to thank you to everyone who's been sharing my videos across their social media. Hey, so there you go, and you all have a very good day. Bye-bye.